Dear students, this is Shivan of a physics lecturer. Today we are going to discuss one of the concept that is Gold-Leaf electroscope. First we have to know definition of Gold-Leaf electroscope or meaning of Gold-Leaf electroscope. The Gold-Leaf electroscope, it is a device which is using for detect presence and nature of electric charge on a body is called a Gold-Leaf electroscope. Written on the board, that is here, see here. It is a device which is using for detect presence and nature of electric charge on a body is called a Gold-Leaf electroscope. So then we are going to discuss working of Gold-Leaf electroscope. So this is the arrangement of Gold-Leaf. So this is, we consider glass rod, and this is a metallic disc, and this is a glass jar, and this is a vertical metallic rod. This is metallic rod, the vertical metallic rod. Both the ends, at the one end, the lower end of this vertical rod, we have gold leaves. This is gold leaves, and this is the metallic disc and the glass rod. This is parts in the Gold-Leaf electroscope. Now we are going to discuss how this Gold-Leaf working. The first we have to discuss working up for Gold-Leaf electroscope. So first, initially I am consider this is glass rod. This is glass rod. Naturally, this glass rod have neutral initially. Okay. Similarly, we consider this is silk cloth. This is glass rod. Already we discussing this concept in the previous class. Here, the glass rod which is rubbed with the silk. At the time, glass rod which is loses the electron and silk cloth which is gains the electron. Any body it gains the electron, it becomes negative. Any body it loses the electron, it becomes positive. Okay, so this is the here glass rod acquired the positive charges on a body. Because of this is positive, glass rod is positive charge due to rubbing of silk cloth. It acquired the negative charges on a body due to rubbing with the glass rod against each other. So this is one of the system. Then this is the second one. Here if we consider fur, this is the fur, and another one is ebonite or plastic rod, or we can say that is rubber rod. This is rubber rod. Here fur which is rubbed with the rubber rod. At the time, due to rubbing against fur as well as rubber rod which is gains the electron, but fur which is loses the electron. When it gains the electron, it becomes negative. So similarly, it loses the electron. For which is loses the electron, it acquired the positive charges on a body. Here for which acquired the positive charges. Okay, just remember these two concepts. So here now we are going to discuss how the Gold-Leaf electroscope which is works. Here this glass rod which is rubbed with the silk, it acquired the positive charges on a body. this positive charged glass rod which is brought to touch to the metallic disc. So already this is charged. Charged in positive charge. Positive charge means which is deficiency of electrons. It required the electrons. So when which is touched to the metallic disc, we have in the gold foil number of electrons as well as positive charges as well as negative charges. So electrons are negative charges, but this is the deficiency of deficiency of electron because of this is the positive charged glass rod. These electrons, they are moving towards the metallic disc and then it will be gets neutralized due to physical contact with the metallic disc. At the time when these electrons move upward to the metallic disc, here it becomes more positive at the ends. It becomes more positive due to flowing of the electron upward. Okay, so when here one positive charge acquire here, another positive charge at the another leaf of the gold house, then same kind of the charges are present at the two ends of the gold leaves. The same kind of the charges, they always repel each other, right? Repel each other. So therefore, these gold foils are gets repelled. Gets repelled. Here positive charges are present at the two halves of the gold leaves. So automatically it will be diverged. Okay, this is one concept. It will be divergence further increases amount of the charges. It will depends on the amount of the charges. If amount of charges increases, divergence of the gold leaves further increases. If amount of the charges decreases, divergence of the gold foil again it is decreases, right? So what happens if you here instead of glass rod, if we kept the rubber rod. Rubber rod. We know that rubber rod having negative charges due to rubbing with the fur. Here we have number of negative charges are present here. So here negative charges means this rubber rod which is having excess of electrons. Excess of electrons. It try to release the electron from this rubber rod because of which is having excess of electron due to rubbing with the fur. So therefore here we have excess of electron. These excess of electron, they are moved towards the metallic disc to the gold leaves. When gold leaves they will move to the gold leaves, they here we have the negative two same kind of the charges are present at the two ends of the gold leaves. Again same kind of the charges are present here, automatically it will be divergence increases. Okay, divergence increases because excess of electron they are moved through the that is a metallic rod to the gold leaves. Here more number of negative charges are present in the gold leaf. Again it will be increases, divergence increases further and further. If amount of charges is increases, divergence of the gold leaves further increases. Totally divergence of the gold leaf which is depends on the amount of the charges, those are presence. If amount of charges increases, divergence also increases. Amount of charges which is decreases, divergence of the gold leaves also decreases. So then one thing you have to remember, how to identify here given body which is a positive charge or negative charge. So for example, initially we have this gold foil having the positive charge, so which is having this much of divergence. If we have we have the positive charges, right? Here positive charges are present initially without physical contact with the this is a glass rod or whatever it may be, glass rod or whatever it may be, without physical contact. Initially this gold foil having positive charges on the two ends, but we don't know this body having the positive or negative. So we have to identify this body is positive or negative by this simple experiment, that is gold leaf electroscope. Here we have the positive charges initially.
So they will be positive charges is there, therefore it will be diverge. Then if we kept here a glass rod, if we kept here glass rod to the metallic disc, this is the glass rod. This is, if we have to identify, this is the positive or negative body. Okay, so when it is touched to the metallic disc, here we have a deficiency of electrons. These electrons, they are moving toward this one. Again here, deficiency of electrons more and more. So deficiency of electrons are more and more. Deficiency of electron more and more. Further here, positive charges increases here at the gold leaf. The divergence is increases. Easily we can identify this given body is positive body. If we have here plastic rod, if you're using here plastic rod, the plastic rod having the negative charges because of it is excess of electrons due to rubbing with the fur. So they, which is touched with a metallic disc, this is excess of electrons, they are moving towards the gold leaves with the help of the metallic rod. These electrons, they come to the gold leaves, they get neutralized, divergence goes on, decreases. It means what? This given body is a negative body. Like this, we can detect the nature of the any bodies by using the simple experiment, that is gold leaf electroscope. Okay, so either you know the gold leaf electroscope, now we explanation model color, not really positive, the positive body, the woman is positive, illa negative one, the good thing, gold leaves are positive charge, it some certain diverse. I get them for a diverse. Adaga illi now in another glass rod, the woman is touch matter. Glass rod, the woman is under a then positive body. I get under a positive body. I get under the name. I electron break. I get the touch matter. The should kill the electron and layer and with the metallic distro either the glass rod go again neutralize. Adaga. ಇಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಹೋಗಿದೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಡೆಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೋರ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಫರ್ದರ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಡೈವರ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಬಾಡಿ ಯಾವ್ದು ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಬೇಕು, ನಾವು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ರಾಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಬಾಡಿ ತಗೊಂಬಂದು ಇದು ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ, ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ಗೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ರಾಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಜೊತೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾವು, ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಲೀಫ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾವ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯಾವ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಬಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಲೈಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನೇಮ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇರೋದು ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಲೈಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಲೈಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೈವರ್ಜೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಇಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಬಾಡಿ ಯಾವುದು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವು ಇದು ಡಿವೈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾವುದು, ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ನ, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಅನೇ ಬಾಡಿ. ಈ ತರ ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಇದು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇದನ್ನ 3 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಈ ತರ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ಗೆ. ಸೊ ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಆನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್.